Hey Spoony, this is my reply to your green screen video you did a while back. Kinda late, I know, but I just thought I might do it now anyway. I've been green screening for about 6 months now, right? And when I first started, that was when I first saw your green screen video, and that's when I... back then, I thought your green screen was the peak of perfection. I thought it was the absolute pinnacle, because it looked perfect. I mean, I'm pretty sure I left a comment saying that even though you hadn't keyed it yet, it looked like the screen had been keyed behind you. But that was back when I was using not a blue screen, I was using my blue duvet pinned up against my wall. Of course, now I've got a proper green screen and whatnot. But in the time between then and now, I've kind of noticed a few little issues with it. I mean, for all I know, you've probably changed it completely by now, and you've probably got like a professional green screen artist to have a look at it, but I don't know, I thought I might as well voice my opinion in case you're still using the same setup. One of the things I noticed, you brought up that someone had said that the screen was the wrong colour, and yeah, I don't think that was it. They thought the green was too bright. What I noticed is I think your lights are a tad too intense all round. Because I noticed because, you know, guys, I guess, because we're so pale, I know, we're all there, the idea is to make the green screen as different to your skin colour as possible. I mean, for clothes, it's simple, you just wear black. But for skin, because it's so bright, because our skin is so bright and, like, tanless, you know, it helps to make the green screen slightly that much darker, just a tad, just to differentiate it a bit. Because when you moved the softboxes back, even though they were illuminating you, I did notice the screen. I could differentiate between you, your hand, and the screen a bit better. Because I took a screenshot of you standing in front of it as at the beginning, where you was kind of like that, or whatever. And I had, you know, even though it keyed okay, I had a bit of an issue with your hand, because you were holding your hand up like that, pointing at the softbox, I think, and I had real difficulty keying that right with the background, because it's about here you had the hot spot, I think, and it was almost white, the hot spot, and your hand, I could barely see it, you know, it was actually blurred into the screen a bit. And well, you know, the only thing I can recommend on top of that is I'd recommend you move the softboxes, you know, if not back that way, if you can, I'd move them a bit further back that way and maybe over a bit, I would. Because, you know, I just saw it's too bright and it's kind of washing out the colour from it, it is. And also, if you dampen the intensity, it will actually decrease the amount of spill that goes over your kind of silhouette, or whatever the word is. But anyway, if I zoom back, I can probably show you my setup. I can probably show you my setup that's based off you. No, hang on, let me just take the camera off. Anyway, right, here's my green screen. It's a full green screen. I always use it like this because I just finished filming my first review attempt. Excuse me, and it is a full-bodied green screen required. Yeah, I know, there's plenty of ripples in it, but After Effects was made to combat them, wasn't it? Anyway, these are my two softboxes. Believe it or not, probably the most budgetized softboxes you can get. Because believe it or not, right, that one there, and that one there, they were probably around, I think, between 10 and 20 quid each. Which is, you know, and yeah, the stands really show how cheap it is. I mean, look, it's going down already. And I haven't unclipped it yet. They are really cheap, but the lights themselves are pretty good. They are just the what are they called now? Energy efficient ones, or I don't know, environmentally friendly. That's it. And they light it up pretty good. If I turn one of them off, you can see the difference. See, so they do light it up pretty well. And yeah, the reason I got them aiming down is because I needed them to illuminate the bottom as well. And yeah, because I got the blinds shut, and it's quite a bright day, it didn't matter so much. Ooh, crap. Right. It didn't matter so much with the bottom or the or me, sort, because I don't have any. I don't have any lights to, you know, kind of illuminate me. Well, I do, but I don't use it really, because the light that I've got to illuminate me is more of a, it's a magna light, it is, you know, like a magnifying glass with a round kind of bulb in it. But I only use that if I really need to, because, I mean, these things, they're lighting me up a bit at the moment, but I've noticed through that, that helps stop the spill, really, because it brightens up the colour around you. And I know you probably disagree, everyone will probably disagree with that, but it works for me, for what I do. But, oh, excuse me. But, well, I'm not really sure what much more I can say, you know. I've said all that needs to be said. That's all I can recommend, is that if on your softboxes you can dial down the brightness a bit, or the intensity, that's the only thing I'd recommend doing, because I've noticed, right, between yours and Angry Joe's, I know this is kind of horrible, me comparing the two, but I've taken two screenshots of the two of you, and Angry Joe's, that, you know, that is perfect, that is. I mean, I'm pretty sure you will say that is just perfection, his one is. I mean, it's unbelievable. But, yeah, what the way, the colour, the, or the intensity that the brightness is on his, that's what I'd recommend you should probably aim for. Because you want to keep as much of the green as possible and not so much white. So that is all I can say. And yeah, I know the light's kind of, but that's because that one fell down. But yeah, well, this is my green screen setup, and I'd love to know what you think of it. I'm not expecting you to subscribe or anything, because, well, I don't know. But anyway, I don't know if you can take my advice or not. I mean, I have 34 subscribers, roughly. And I've been on you for 6 months, so, you know, you can probably tell I'm not doing that well. But, yeah, well, this is my budget chroma key set, so I'd love to know what you think. And let me know what changes you think I can make to this. And, well, thanks. Hope you enjoyed the video. And, well, check out some of my other stuff if you want. See you, dude. Keep on rocking.